Welcome back, this is Coda. About to do mission number 20, I believe. I'm on day 7, I think. So my goal is to reach the end of day 10, and there's maybe like 5 or so more missions before then. So all these ones that I have for options, of those, I'm actually thinking about hitting the cybernetics lab. It's level 7 is kind of the lowest of all the missions. There's this executive terminals, which might be interesting, but I have a few options already. And like I said, it was really unfortunate that I couldn't get any upgrades on the augment slots last time, because that's really the only way I'm going to increase my character power. I'm pretty much full on items, most items. So yeah, I'll be hitting this up.
The corporations make a brisk trade selling augments.
I do have
public,
a few EMPs, even though I don't have.
For themselves. We can get some quality time with an augment implanter if we.
Even though I don't have any lethal weapons, which is kind of a bummer. I can still hack robots to kill each other.
Corporate firewall.
And I might be doing quite a bit of that this run. No blowfish. Please, no blowfish. Item cooldowns short-circuited. What the f- was that? Adding 3 to all cooldowns. That's actually not that bad, I don't think. Okay, let's go ahead and have Banks do the first move. Could also have her go ahead and use, man, 8 turn cooldown. That's kind of ridiculous. I could wait for this. I could, like, if I have 8 turn cooldown, realistically I can only get 2-3 if I'm really lucky this run. So it might be better for me to just get power from this thing instead of, and hope for a better higher level console. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move this girl first over here. I want her to get out of the way for this door. Actually, yeah, they all have the same bonus to this. Yeah, whoops. Didn't necessarily need to use Nika right here. Could have a camera right there. 6 action points. So Buster Chip has what cooldown? 6 turn cooldown. So I could Buster Chip this one. To note, I moved the portable server onto him. The issue with that is, I would be blocking the way. I'm gonna move her up. She's gonna have the most action points of all the people in this. For this turn, since she'll get a little more from the augment. Okay. So I am kind of. Okay, so I hear a drone here. Console database. I hear a drone this way. So it could be facing this door. I think what I want to do is check out this doorway first. Almost guaranteed that I need to open this door. They do have local scanners on most of these things. Alright, this almost certainly is the exit. If I do another peek, I'm going to be on really low action points. This does look like a fairly safe room if there's nothing in this room, because nothing's going to open. Okay, so I can end my turn in this room. I could do that right now, or I could wait for just a moment. I think I'll move. She has 8 action points. She has 6. Alright. She can go back one spot. Alright, so this is a little unfortunate because I can't use an action point to see where he goes and also move back here. I could open the door. Shoot him with my tag pistol, maybe? I'm not sure if I have full line of sight. But if I do, then I can, if that does work, then I can have more action points. The downside is, if that doesn't work, then this guy's gonna come here and possibly scan me. If he's in this room. What does this room suggest to me? Like, there's a doorway right here. Alright, I'm gonna risk it. Alright. Can I get the shot off? I cannot. I could move over one. I think that might give me the shot that I'm looking for. I really want to see where this guy goes. This thing is hidden. It's hidden from that thing as well. I could also stim if this doesn't work. This is worth the action. Yeah. Three more action points. That was from her augment here. Which goes well with the tag pistol. So this guy goes into this room. So that means I technically could get right here. I should probably peek first though. Something could have vision right here. Or it could have a camera right there. Okay, so nothing has vision of this particular spot. So this is a level 3. This is a level 1. What can I do? So, given this, I want to try to do most of my hacking, or use most of my programs over my items, because my items are going to be on super long cooldowns. Well, Buster Chip is not that bad, but... So this means I'll probably... I most likely want to use Hunter on this. No, I'm saying think about that. So if I use Parasite on this thing, and then plan on... No, if I use Parasite, then I'm pretty much forced to, at some point, deal with the demon. Since it's only level 3, I can possibly use a lockpick on this thing and then have him use his augment, his local EMP. That's probably best. That's going to cost me 3 power, but I don't necessarily have to deal with the... demon on it. So in that case, I'll probably use a lockpick. A lockpick at this point is going to cost me less to use a lockpick here and then use parasite level 2 on this thing. Okay. Alright, also, this is a little unfortunate. She's going to block her moving here, which is probably where I want her to go. So I could have her move backwards. Don't really want her to be in this side. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. Have her move to this side. Might want to put down another parasite on something. If I have her move here. Oh shit, I need to close that door. Alright, should have closed that door. Oh, they would have been at the same spot. Okay. So I did bring along the vault access card, and it could be used for emergency escape right there. So the positioning here suggests that I should be able to safely go on this side of the room. Let me think about that. Fuck. You know what I should have done? I should have given Banks the portable server. What if I drop the portable server like right here? Like in front of this doorway? Or I could just try not to have it. I could try it not to have anyone move into this room. I think right here is fine. Like right here. I'll pick it up before I exit. There wasn't any cameras in this room, so that's good. I will close that door, and I will move. I think this is safe. I mean, it's pretty unlikely that a robot goes all the way in here and then goes into this particular spot. Alright. Could put a level 0 parasite on this thing. Start hacking that. Could also put a level 0 on this nanofab. Start hacking that. And with the intention of using Hunter on this thing next turn. If I want to hack this nanofab, I should hack it now, right? Or I should probably plan on using Hunter next turn on it. Could also use one on this thing and just have it tick down. It's not going to increase this thing. Console database, don't really need that. Alright. This looks good. Alright. Almost certainly want to start using the cooldown on this thing. Might want to get more power from this console as well. Okay, so there was. I can't tell, but I think this thing is in front of the door. I think it was like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I think his like movement from here to here. So this guy is gonna, he ends his turn like standing right here, I believe it was. It was like, he was right in front of the door. So I could move over here and plan on picking his pocket next turn. I otherwise wouldn't be able to. No, let's see. If he stays right here, I should be able to actually go here, steal from him, and then come back around here. It would alert him to, like, maybe movement right here. Safe spot should be, like, definitely right here is safe. I could also go here, open the door, come back, and, like, be... This is 5. Open the door, peek. 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. No. Okay. Alright. Let's go ahead and move this first. I really don't want to unlock this door. Do I want to unlock this door? Not really. Let's try to swing around it first. Alright, this looks like the cybernetics lab. Oh wow, so it's just plain empty. Okay. That's pretty interesting layout. So, Banks is probably gonna have to... Wait, there's nothing here? Okay, so Banks is probably gonna have to unlock this door. So the issue here is also if there's a camera facing... I can't see how there'd be a camera. No, there could be a camera in there. There could be a door. So if there is a camera and it spots me there, that's gonna be kind of bad. So I could move Dr. Zhu like maybe one step in. He's probably gonna have to go towards this thing anyway, so... Holy shit. Forgot that there was a camera there. That's a good thing I didn't move like over here. That would have been really bad. Okay, let's go ahead and peek here. Okay, so he was in this door. So he goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think he ends up here. Okay. I do wish I could see right here. I wonder if I go here and peek, if I'd be able to see. Okay, so there's no camera there. That is something. Alright, so this guy... So this is an Omni Harbinger, and he has the long patrol route. So he actually doesn't... So my assumption there, he actually doesn't come back here. This guy also has a long patrol route. Actually, I'm not sure how I have vision on him. The fuck? Okay, I mean, I don't know how I thought I had, somehow saw his patrol. I think I probably want to spend one of our action points seeing his movement. Okay, this guy is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. He's probably right here. This guy is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, maybe? The question I have is actually, does he see this doorway opening? And my suspicion is yes. I also want to see where he goes back. Double check on his movement. Okay, so he goes one step through the doorway and one over here. I sort of want to kill him somehow, if that's at all feasible. There's a beam that prevents me from flanking him, kind of. Alright, so I think this should probably be the first thing. Get more power or weight. I don't see any real consoles, so I think I might want to use this for the Econ chip right now. Yeah. Go here, Econ chip. And who knows, maybe I can find another Econ chip in this thing. Alright, so this is safe. Which is good. I think what I'll have Dr. Zhu do is he'll play around in this room. So once the camera drone comes here, maybe he can open the door, lure the camera into this room, hide here, kill the camera here, and then get to these safes. Does waste a fair amount of his time though. Is there any quick way of doing that? I could use a cloak. That seems also kind of wasteful. All right, I'm gonna test this guy. He doesn't actually get all the way to the door, so.
Did you see that?
That's fine. So he just barely got, that was probably the edge of his notice zone. Oh gosh. Now that sucks. Level 3. Yeah. Well, I sort of need to do that in order to start hacking this thing. I think it makes sense for me to use a level 2 parasite on this thing. This is going to take 2 turns. I could also use a level 1 parasite on it and then plan on using lockpick. Alternatively, I could also use lockpick on one of these, and then that'll reduce this thing to 1 power, and then put that, and then use another lockpick there next turn. I don't want to have to wait 2 turns for this. So 3, which is also saved a little bit by her. I hadn't used the second power there, so put a level 1 here. Next turn, use another lockpick on it. Actually, have I used both? Did I get both powers from her? So I could use another lockpick on this thing and put a level 0 on this thing. That would be a net 1. Net 1 loss. Seems a little wasteful, but it's not that bad. Don't want to do that on this thing. I could start hacking this thing. I think I probably need to use her. Actually, fuck. Oh, gosh, she doesn't have line of sight on this shot. I think I probably want to use one action point just to see where he goes. I could do it this turn. I could also do it next turn. I want to do it this turn because I don't think I have line of sight on this thing next turn. That does give her 3 more action points. Okay. So the question is whether I want to start hacking this thing. Committed to using a lockpick on this thing next turn. Let's use one for action points to see where this guy goes. Wow, really? So I'm pretty sure this guy probably moved before this guy because he's not blocking his patrol. Wow, that's kind of a bummer. Okay, so what happens? This guy goes here. Wait, there's another camera in this room? Oh gosh. Okay, I think I need to hack this one as well. Also put a level 1 here. Man, I'm committed to using a lot of lockpicks. Yeah. This is level 2. Committed to using a lot of lockpicks. Okay, so what I can do is I can get him to get over here, open the door, and play peekaboo right here with him. He has a local scanner, but the local scanner is probably... Oh, he doesn't have a notice zone either, right? He has a full watch zone. So I don't actually know. I might want to just leave the doorway open right here and just be on this side. And then steal from him, close the door, and then run out. Steal from him, close the door, run out. Like, I can only do that once. I could also start opening and closing this door afterwards. He doesn't see that though. Yeah, he doesn't see that door. Alright. That means... what does that mean? That probably means I need to go back into this room. So if I steal from him, yeah, okay. I leave the doorway open, kind of, and then I can let him go back that way. If I close the door, then he goes into this room, and then I swing behind him, maybe. I think, would I want him to just be in this room for a bit? It's gonna cause him to basically take 2 turns. I can decide that later, okay. Of Question is where I want to go with him. He can't go through this way, that's kind of blocked. All these ways are kind of blocked. Maybe I should start hacking him. Actually, I could hack him next turn using someone's Buster Chip. That seems like the best method. Since then, I can actually maybe go around. Looks decent. So I could transfer a Buster Chip over here, Buster Chip this thing. This thing's gonna walk into here and maybe get sat on. This guy is currently standing facing this way, but he shouldn't actually see the doorway. This is also EMP vulnerable, so just a single hack on, just a single EMP on this thing is not going to kill it. So assume I use Buster Chip on this thing. Probably just want to hack this side. Okay. Could tag this thing. What I sort of want to do here is, I actually sort of want to like close this doorway somehow. So let's assume I Buster Chip this guy. Move him into this room. Cloak, and then move across here. If I could somehow lure this guard to be on this side of the door, and then just keep him preoccupied on this side. Let me think, how would that work? If I can get him onto this side, which could mean something like, I could, if I just close this door using a cloaked version of Dr. Zhu, let's say, and then he's gonna go over here instead, move this guy into this room, and then Dr. Zhu is basically going to be trapped in this room with this guy almost indefinitely. Until he has to knock him out, maybe. If Dr. Zhu is in this room, Is there a way for Dr. Zhu to get out of this room without using cloak? Possibly if someone opened the door on this side, the guard will therefore switch position to face this way. And then, Dr. Zhu could swing around back. Alternatively, I could just have like Nika cloak. After I hack this, Nika cloak open and close this door, or close this door from this side. This guy's gonna go here. These guys can swing around after he comes to this spot, and that shouldn't affect Dr. Zhu. Okay. Okay, so I believe the local scanner doesn't go through walls. And I think I can safely use lockpick on this thing. And that'll let me use... Actually... Not sure if that was strictly necessary. I will move this guy a little. I was planning on using a level 1 parasite on this thing, that's right. So that when I EMP it, it dies. Wait, what? It's not Oh, there's no EMP protection on that thing? Huh, I thought there was. Okay, so I don't have to put a parasite on that thing. Even better. I'll move a little further away. There's no particular reason why I need to be close to this spot. All right, so I'll probably have her use her invisibility right here. Who's gonna get into the most trouble? Nika's probably gonna get into most trouble. So, nah. I guess Nika has the least movement action point, so. What if I have this guy move into this room hacked? Close the door, shoot this thing. I could have done that this turn. So this guy, I am gonna close this door. He doesn't see the fucking door. All right. Could steal from him. That ruined almost everything. Alright, there is an extra cybernetics lab here.
You located the cyber lab. Let's leave this mission with better agents than we started with.
Technically, I could use a buster chip on this thing. If I use a level 1 here, I could use a buster chip next turn on it. Oh gosh, this guy's gonna just block my doorway indefinitely. Alright, so I'll just swing around here. Yeah, I'll swing around behind him, steal from him behind, maybe even close this door so that he gets stuck in this thing. Just make sure that this thing's active so I can't go in front of this. I could actually even stay. No. I could stay. Actually, no. There's no safe spot here. This guy's gonna be in this room, so if I go into this area, it probably has to be over here. Unless, well, no, as long as I'm not detected, right? He's gonna scan, he's gonna find something here, but will he actually move towards it that turn? I think he scans at the end of his movement. Scans. No, 1-2. No, I can't risk it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nah, can't risk that either. I need her to be like over here. Well, no, he needs to be the one closest to the door. So she can be like right here. Almost 100% certain that it doesn't go through doorways to scan, so. How far can she go? She can go maybe. She can go maybe right here and then swing over here, open, close this door, have him spend an extra turn here. Is that strictly necessary or can she just go into this room? Go here, pick his pocket. I could also have, where do I want to have this guy? Probably waiting in this room. I guess this is kind of okay right there. Alright. Well, I could even have him shoot this thing. I don't really want to have it killed here though, do I? Not really. Let's go ahead and put level 1 on that. Oh shit. That was bad. I think I might have wanted to put a level 2 on this thing. Alright. Level 1 on this. She's probably gonna have to figure out what happens here.
Huh? There's nothing here.
Looking around. Nothing.
Alright, at least this guy is actually. At least that didn't cause him to go on. Go on hunt mode. Oh gosh, this guy is actually moving to this area. So I do need to delay him in this room. Actually, that's fine. Not even protected. Yeah. Fortunately, I can't shoot him there. Okay. Okay, so I can't get all the way over here. I could probably do that on her though. Get all the way over here. I'm guessing I want to hack this thing this turn. That'll lower the cost of future parasites. All right. Definitely gonna use one action point to see where he goes. All right, so he just basically goes one step farther.
Did you see that?
Okay, there's that. He's stationary in the room. Oh good, he actually gets all the way over here. So I could hide here, steal, and then come back here, and then he might not actually have to, I might not actually have to deal with him this level. I guess this is probably the safest spot. Okay. I'll need someone to camp this guy's body. I might have Dr. Zhu do that. Yeah, Dr. Zhu can't go all the way over here anyways. Okay, so he can move 2 diagonals, so he could get to the safe and then come back on it. Alright, she can move all the way over here, steal, open, close this door, but then she actually doesn't. She only has 3 more action points. So that's not great. I can have her... I could have her, say, move here, 8, 9, 10, 11, or 8, 1, 2, 3. He sees this spot. Steal. 4, 5, 6, 7. Steal. And then what? She just needs a little more action points to get. If only she could use her Buster Chip or some Buster Chip on this thing, that'd be enough action points. This is really the fastest way, so I could then move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. See, there's the issue there is once he gets, like, he might stop here, but once he gets here, there's no stopping him from doing his other movements. What if I did something like... What if I stemmed? What if I stemmed? Stemmed her. Open, close this door. Stem. Get her over to this area. I don't know what happened to the other dude. Yes, this stem is probably most reasonable here. But then, wait, if I stem, he comes here. At that point, I could have him open and close this door. And get him to move into this side. I could do that like this turn as well. No. I have to go there to steal from him.
Did you see that?
Actually, have I tagged him? I have tagged him. Okay. Alright, there's... I have to be careful right here. He actually comes back. There's a patrol that comes back. Through this area. I think I probably want to be here. Maybe I want to be super safe and go here even. I don't think he sees all the way down here. I'm not even sure that he sees right here, but he might. Everywhere else seems a little dangerous. Pretty sure he shouldn't see this. And technically, he's gonna be there next turn, and I'm actually gonna follow him after he goes here, so. Oh shit, that's right. I need to get this card off of him. So if I open and close this door, I'll probably have Nika do that. Lost a lot of wasted movement here. Nika, 4 turns on the Buster chip. Probably not going to have to use the EMP. Probably not going to have to use the Volt Disruptor. Technically, not the Tag Pistol, right? I'll keep the Volt Disruptor just in case. Okay. And actually, I might have her be the one that opens and closes. No, no. Don't need that, don't need that, or that.
Yeah, we're having a look. Guess it was nothing.
Guess it was nothing.
This would have been safe. Alright, almost certainly. Well, regardless, I'm gonna add an augmented slot.
Head office is catching on to us. Several devices have been remotely rebooted. I hope we don't run out of power.
That's a little unfortunate. Several devices. Like all the cameras. Okay. Man, there's like no safe spot here. Like maybe this spot. It's 6 right now. I'm probably gonna have to use a lockpick on maybe this thing. No, I'll probably have to use lockpick on one of the cameras. Alright, so this guy actually comes back. So there could be a camera right here, or even right here in this area. I already used them, so it's not really safe for me to go farther. Although I really would like to go here. Might be time to use cloak. Yeah, I think it's time to use cloak on her. Fortunately, this guy is probably he's gonna end his turn here. Fuck. Okay. I guess that's fine. If I go here, I might have to go here next turn. Okay. Alright, so seems like I want to use lockpick here. Thank you. have him open and close this door and then come back here. And basically make sure that he stays. Actually, he's not going to be able to stay here for long. He might stay here for one turn. Reason being is that I don't have a safe way of actually getting to this door. He's going to notice the movement right here. But one turn isn't that bad. Is he going to see me open this door right here? No, this door should have cover.
Did you see that?
Yeah. Actually, 4, 1, 2, 3. Can I shop? One, two, three. Am I one diagonal possible? If I'm not one diagonal, then I'm kinda... then it's gonna be kinda bad for me. I guess I only shop this turn anyways. So, gonna need a hack on this, and maybe possibly put a lockpick on one of these. Actually, I probably just want to lockpick one of these this turn. Alright, she does have her buster chip, so that's good. It might have been best if I actually had opened this door and peeked around here. The guy would have stopped his turn here anyways. Yeah, that was too bad. Actually, if I do another lockpick here, that means I could probably get here, use Econ chip. Okay, not enough movement. That's too bad. I should have ended the turn there. Whoops. Technically, I think this should be safe right here. Would this guy see it? Probably don't want to risk it. Alright, let's go ahead and put level 1 parasite on this. Did I not put... no, yeah, yeah.
Investigating area. I must be jumpy tonight.
Alarm level 1. Additional cameras activated. Surveillance level increased.
Okay, so this guy goes there. I think he... I'm not sure if he patrols further than that. I could actually open and close this door right here, and he can... Do I want to do that? Okay, so this guy was here last turn. He's probably back here this turn. I probably want to try to stem over to this thing and maybe use a lockpick on this thing. And if I do that, then I can use this thing this turn. It would provide me with 8 action points, so I go here, 1, 2, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, possibly 8, but right here should be fine. Okay. Pretty sure this room's empty. And I'm pretty sure I want to do the stem here. Okay, I can even wrap around. This is going to be costing me 3 otherwise. Don't necessarily need to do that one. Doesn't matter. Alright. So there's a camera here. Don't want to have him stay here. Almost certainly want to use a level 2 on this thing. If not an EMP, but probably a level 2 parasite, use Hunter on this thing next turn. Oh shit, this girl has the Econ chip, doesn't she? Actually, let me think. Level 2 on this thing, level 1 on this thing next turn, have her... Is it more important for me to hack this thing using Hunter now? The Hunter tool cooldown is going to be pretty important here. If I use an EMP in this spot, it could work. If I use an EMP, then I can't use Hunter on this thing. If I use Hunter on this thing, then I don't know if I have enough cooldowns for this thing. Yeah, that probably was a little premature. I should have used Hunter cooldown this turn for seed. If I do 5, no, 1, 2, then I'd be committed to using 6 power to use two lockpicks on this thing, and then use an EMP to finish it off. In that case, I can In that case, I can... Oh, what can I do? Technically, I probably want to do something like EMP this thing down by two. What if I next turn use EMP and then the following turn use Hunter? I want to use Hunter next turn. Alright, almost certainly a level one there. If I could somehow get... No, Dr. Zhu is just going to be in this spot. Doesn't stack the KOs. That's too bad. Also, I don't know if there's more cameras in this room. That's rough as well. I think I just want to use Hunter on this thing. Next turn. And I think that's... Another server. Another server is pretty nice. Don't need another Buster Chip. But I will take this. That much power, I can definitely use. Sorry, just using. Yeah. Probably want to get another hack going. Not that one. Probably just a level one on one of these. Thirteen action points wasted. All right, first things first. Lockpick on that one. Okay. Yep. Level 5, okay. Gosh, if this has a... This has a camera. Seeing this body, I'm gonna be so pissed. Okay. And she has a Buster Chip, which is good. I don't really know. This is the girl I want to have an extra alchemist slot, but. I definitely probably want to position her in this side. It'll cost me 3 to do this thing immediately. I probably want to do this immediately. Can't really wait. Since I'm going to be knocking myself out. Oh my lord, are you? Okay. You can only have 4? Okay. So, she's gonna have to move over here next turn. And I'll probably need to get the Econ chip from her. Go ahead and hack this thing with a level 2. Could start a level 1 hack on this one, but not strictly necessary. Okay, so this guy goes here, this guy goes here. If I move this guy off of him, probably no point in doing that. Actually, next turn I might even move him over here, open and close this door, so that they're both stalled. Do I want to possibly put a level 1 on this thing? Probably not necessary. Wow, she has 15 action points and she does nothing. Maybe I want to try to. Nope. Could technically have him move over here. No. I think that's it. All right, one more turn for that. Maybe I should have put a parasite level 1 on this thing. I can use 6 to start hacking and to just break it this turn. If I do that, then I can at least move into this room. Oh gosh. Give her the Econ chip and the fresh buster chip. I might even try to use. Can I charge this thing? Charge reduces cooldown by 2. Okay. I might try. No, I can't stem here. I could try cloaking here. but I'm pretty sure I want to just have these two be stuck in this area.
Did you see that?
If I do two lockpicks on this, that'll actually cost me 5. Since I get one back from Prism, I could then move across this room. Yeah, I think that's actually worth it. I already have enough power gain. Oh, and the first one didn't even cost that much. Oh my gosh. I actually did not know that this could be a spot for a camera. It's just with a little crevice here. Fuck. Okay. Obviously, I have to back out. I think that means that someone goes to investigate this. But I'm not quite sure. It could be that the person that comes to investigate comes from over here. Alright, so this means I probably do a level 1 here and then lockpick it next turn. That seems safe, right? Wow, that was really unfortunate. But lesson learned. Next turn. Oh shit. I don't know if I have enough power to do this next turn. Actually, maybe I want to be over here. I guess over here is fine. If I do 2 on this thing, no, that's wasteful. Yeah. I actually probably should have cloaked here. No, I don't have cloak, that's right. Oh, maybe I should have transferred her cloak. Fuck.
Investigating. Must be imagining things. Looking around. I must be jumpy tonight.
Oh gosh, he's investigating this thing too. Alright. Oh, I might have wanted to use Hunter there. Whoops. Alright. Just infinite powers. I wonder if I like move into this guy's notice zone right here, whether or not he'll just investigate this area, find nothing, and then go back into his corner. Otherwise he's gonna go all the way over here. So I can't dance into this notice zone right here because this guy will see it. Oh, are they both investigating for some reason? That's no good. All I wanted was just one more usage of the Econ chip. Is that too much to ask? I think I will dance in this guy's line of sight. This guy's just gonna walk all the way freaking over here.
Hey, what was that?
I should have Ooh, I can get into this guy's movement right here as well. And then maybe go here. Yeah. Let's see if I can't short circuit these guys. And then I think actually I want to be behind them. And they're actually not facing this doorway, so I can actually move this agent next turn over here. Alright, so as for him, he could move here, open and close this door, but then... and then go back here. What would that do for me? I mean, that delays both these guys in this room another turn. Whatever. I don't necessarily need these guys to be delayed for another turn. Alright, that's fine.
I guess I'm just a little amped. Okay, we're investigating. Absolutely nothing going on.
Oh, whoops. I should have used a level 2 parasite on this thing. Okay, so these guys seem likely to go back to their usual positions. They don't have the question mark on them anymore. I can double check with her. She just wants to somehow get this Econ chip usage on this console. Let's see, if she gets over here, okay. All programs cost 2 cooldown plus 1 power. Okay. Oracle. Wonder if this is useful. Oh, repair site. Four power for a random camera. I guess if the cameras were really high, I do make pretty good use of hunt parasite with versus like with lockpick. Oh gosh. I mean, technically, this is pretty good at the start of the turn with seed. I'm just worried about always using parasite. Random camera. If it's level 1, lockpick. If it's level 2, if it's level 3 is the main issue. Because level 3, 2 lockpicks is pretty bad, and waiting 2 turns for parasite is pretty bad. Waiting like 1 turn for parasite plus lockpick is not that bad. Alright. Whatever. So this guy is right there. Could technically move her. Well, I can stall him somehow. Oh, I should have. Maybe I can use invisibility cloak next turn. I can transfer invisibility cloak to her. Yeah, I can do that. So I can move. Alright, I need. Just a little more action points. No, can't really do that either. I was gonna say if I could get to the side of the door, but the side of the door here is spotted. So exactly how am I gonna get past this guy? Hope that he just turns around. I can get past him by using invisibility cloak, getting over here, and then he's gonna go over here, and then I get past him. Okay. So if I want to use invisibility cloak, I probably just want to be right here, so she can do the transfer right here. So. Alright, none of these matter. I'm pretty sure this wall provides me cover, even though it doesn't look very like she's hugging it very well. I'll just put a parasite on something. And maybe another parasite on that thing. Oh, that's unfortunate. Oh, that's unfortunate. This guy's actually gonna mess up this right here. I think what I can do is I could move her into this spot and then move back here. She doesn't have the augment. What if I... So she goes here, uses the Econ ship, goes back here. I would need for her to somehow get into this notice zone and then go back here after I open and close this door. He's still going to be seeing the doorway though. That's not good. What if I got her over here and then stimmed and get over here? Alright, that's fine. Alright, so she's gonna stim her. She's... She's gonna pick up the cloaking ring. Go ahead and cloak.
Did you see that? Did you see that?
So both these guys, this guy goes here, does that. 100% certain that this is safe. This gal needs to get over here and then go around here. Maybe she can get even... Does she rather want to be here? Or even here. Well, she goes here, then goes back here. So here, 7, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Goes here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That should be fine.
What the? Nothing. Looking around. Nothing.
All right, so both these guys have just 16 action points this turn. Ridiculous amounts of action points. This girl first. If I can break something, they get 2 more action points. Which way is closer? That way is closer. I do need to get the other portable server before I forget. Can I do that next turn? Stay down, buddy. Actually, there's a chance that there's a camera here. Alright, pretty good. We got 3 augment slots there. So, even though I didn't pick up actual augments, but that means have the possibility of getting like torque injectors and net downlink at some point for all my characters. Actually, he should have gotten an augment slot.
Nothing like a little self-improvement session to make our task a bit easier. Nice work.
Thank you. Didn't get very good usage of the Econ chip, but what can you do? I think I got 2. Yeah, these things, these Sankaku, don't have a lot of income. I actually only saw like, what was it, 1 Obaka drone and 1 camera drone. I thought there'd be more machinery.
I've got something you might be interested in. I need a quick decision. This thing's hot.
I can't understand why anyone would use that. Alright. Looks like next time it's still day 7, so maybe one of these Sankaku missions as well. Well, hope you guys enjoyed that, and I'll see you guys then. Bye.